All right, compare septicemia, SIRS, and sepsis. What are the differences? Well, this gets very confusing. Mind the little star up there. This will work for a specialty CEU, I believe. So, the American College of Chest Physicians and the Society of Critical Care Medicine has established four different levels of sepsis. The levels and symptoms are as follows. 1, systemic inflammatory response syndrome, which is SIRS. You've probably heard of SIRS before. And this gives you a list of things that a person has SIRS, signs and symptoms that we have. You've got hypothermia, that means your temperature is below 97, or a fever, a temperature above 100. Tachycardia, which is your heart's tachypnea, rapid breath, more than 20 breaths per minute. Let's see if I can say this one. Hypocapnia. I don't think I said that right. Arterial, your CO2 is less than 32. And leukopenia or leukocytosis, your white blood count is off. It's either too low or too high. And there is no confirmed infectious process in SIRS. Okay? So, what happens when you go to the next level? Well, you have sepsis. And sepsis is SIRS, everything that we just talked about before, in response to a confirmed infectious process. Okay? They see the infection. They know where it's at. Then, number 3, severe sepsis. So what happens when it graduates, I guess you could call it, severe sepsis, it includes the dysfunction of one organ, one or more organs. You get hypotension, you get hypoperfusion, and it's going to affect one or more organs. Then, 4, it can turn into septic shock. Sepsis with persistent arterial hypotension or hypoperfusion despite adequate fluid resuscitation. And last, septicemia, which is a serious, life-threatening infection that gets worse very quickly. It can arise from infections throughout the body, including infections in the lung, abdomen, and the urinary tract, and it may come from before or at the same time as the infection is found. And what's really scary is that older people sometimes suffer that, and they'll get like a urinary tract infection, and it just goes through the body, and their body starts shutting down organs. Here is osteomyelitis, which is an infection of the bone. Central nervous system would be meningitis, and you know, you've heard stories about, you know, somebody that got sick. Next thing you know, they're do a spinal tap, they've got meningitis, and they're gone very quickly. Endocarditis, an infection of the heart muscle. Other tissues. Here is a picture of a person that has septicemia, and it had started in their legs, and you can see there's a wound there, and there's lots of swelling. There's a rash usually, and it'll go very quickly. So sepsis, we go back to sepsis, is a medical condition in which the immune system goes into overdrive, all right, releasing chemicals into the blood to combat an infection. These microbes in the blood, urine, lung, skin, or other tissues that trigger widespread inflammation. And this is a cellular injury in the body, in the tissues of the body. If the body is not able to regulate the immune response, which you can see this redness and swelling, and like I said, sometimes a rash, it then overwhelms normal blood processes. So the blood is not able to do its job. The first mention of the word sepsis in a medical context was more than 2,700 years ago in the poems of Homer, which I thought was really cool, and I would have loved to have went and looked at time to go in and find that. The word derives from a Greek word sepion, meaning to rot, and that's exactly what happens. Sepsis occurs in 1 to 2% of all of the hospitalizations in the United States, affecting at least 750,000 persons and costing $17 billion a year to treat. A term sometimes used for sepsis is blood poisoning, but there's no poison involved in sepsis. And this is the most, how would I say, benign picture that I could find. And my husband and children think that I'm very morbid and like gory pictures, but just go in and Google image sepsis. Amazing what you can find in really sad conditions too for people. And this stuff can happen just like that.
Get more CPC exam tips, coding certification training, and CEU credits. Go to www.codingcertification.org.